can stop at one of seven places, and if they get bored, they just go outside and catch another trolley, because they run like buses. It's from one place to another. Give them $15 each. My parents had a lot of Benny Goodman records, and I got, as a little kid, started listening to them down the basement. They were the old 78 records. And they had a Louis Prima and a Wingy Minone and stuff like that. And I really got into it, and then I heard Louis Armstrong over the radio in 1942, and I couldn't believe a guy could get that tone, just play Dixie, I think he played. It was something. Hiya, Marianne. Well, I learned to play when I was in grade school. I played the clarinet, and then when I went to high school, I learned to play the sax. And I played in the band in high school, and then I played in the marching band at Stanford. Then I started having to go in the service, started having kids and everything, and I kind of let it go on. I've become a very good listener. Hi, Sylvia.
Hi, Wes. You moved to Sarasota. Tell us about this club and what happened there.
Well, I didn't even know there was a club. I was up in Boston calling on accounts, and I heard this great disc jockey, Ron Delacasey. I still remember his name. Then I said, I actually live in Sarasota now. He said, well, aren't you lucky? My friend Hal Davis has a jazz club down there. And he gave me the number, I called and joined. But the Jazz Trolley started in 97.
Have you been doing it most of the time
too? I've been on the, I was just on the committee the first year, and for 11 years I've been the head man. Uh-huh. It gives you a good feeling, because never in our history has jazz been the stuff that everybody liked. But the people that love it, and they stick together.
Besides music, tell us your other passions.
Well, I like to play bridge, social bridge, with my girlfriend Grace, with other couples. And then I like tennis. Sometimes I play 6 days a week.
Now tell me about your family.
My family, I was the oldest of six kids. And then I started off, and we had mostly boys, but I had all girls. And I'm very happy. Daughters come back to me and really help their daddy. Well, because they pay attention to their dad, and they call me, and we get involved a lot. And it's, sons don't always do that.
Very good. Okay, we'll catch you a little bit
later. Okay, good.
You're doing good.
Thank
all
you.
Right, I'm just going to follow you a little
okay.
bit.
This one is the route, and make sure the driver has one.
Good plan.
Yeah. You need seven people to go on that one.
What's it like working with my dad? Wonderful. Why is that?
I don't know. Who is your dad?
My dad. That's my, oh, I'm the daughter.
Oh, is this your daughter?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Oh, well, he's really great to work with.
How much does he love jazz?
He loves jazz, like I do.
Yeah, she does, and she's a singer, and her husband was a musician, too, and unfortunately, we don't have him anymore.
No.
Maybe he's here in spirit.
Yes, he is.
Always.
That's
always in spirit. No, your dad has been wonderful to work with. Ding, ding, ding went the trolley. Cling, cling, cling went the bell. Zing, zing, zing went my heartstrings. And the moment I saw you, I fell.
Yay! Hey!
The Jazz Trolley, and he's all excited, so we thought we're doing a video. Yeah, but he's in the jazz club. He's vice president, so.
This is
the little brother.
How are you?
This is the little brother.
Matt McCooley.
Yeah.
Gary Deary. Tony Martin. I'm Debbie Keene. It's good having you. We're going to take a short break. We'll be right back. Don't go away. Yeah. Or if you don't want to come back.
My cash out, cash. I forgot to erase that payment. I'm going to sneak in front of you, buddy.
St. Thomas Way. Has anybody been to the Virgin Islands? Yeah? You have? Don't you think they should change their name?
Yeah. This is one of my dad's favorite songs.
St. Thomas Way. I know how to be too high and sound in my shoes. To feel some relief from all those typical blues. No cold socks and no broken backs. It's just
about the fact that it's your dad that put it all together.
I think it was one of his best ideas, and I think he's a real asset to the jazz club.
My name is Judge Wesley Bearden II, and this is my moment in time.